comes from Ahmed, who's a postdoc researcher in the UK. How to convince an employer that you are not overqualified? And this is really interesting because my best friend, who's got her doctorate, I sat with her for a long time, about 2 years ago, and she got her first role, and this was an issue for her, that you are not overqualified and only interested in this job as a stepping stone until something better comes along. Now, obviously, if it's a position that is very obviously just a stepping stone, that's a very different issue. But if it's a, and we can obviously address that later, but if this is a position that you really, really want to get, and you are not using this as a stepping stone, but that person doesn't believe you, Chris, what advice would you have to somebody going through that situation? Because that could be really frustrating.
Yeah, I mean, I think the first thing I say is often these kinds of fears can be in your own head, not necessarily how the employer is looking at you. But anyway, it is quite important to be able to get over them. I mean, I think the piece of advice I give to everybody is to not sort of think of yourself as a PhD, but think of yourself as a professional X, and within that X, in your own sort of phrase. So are you a professional researcher, a professional marketing expert, a professional diversity consultant, professional translator, and actually really sell yourself and present yourself as a professional. So in that way, everything else that you've got actually supports that professionalism. The PhD is just one example of that. And so anyway, that's usually my advice to people who are thinking this way, is to actually try and present your thinking and actually really communicate your value.
Yeah, because it could be in your head. You're absolutely right. I think most of our limiting beliefs are in our head. Back on, I'm going to take this up if that's okay. So firstly, I would say that you are not overqualified. You are exactly qualified. And there is no problem telling somebody that, do you know what? Interesting that you do think that I'm overqualified. That's really interesting. But I would say, and I genuinely believe, that I'm exactly qualified. I'm perfectly qualified, not overqualified, perfectly qualified. And I think sometimes that it's so much more than the position. And you have to remember that. It's the organization. It's the team that you're going into. It's so much more than just the job and the job duties and the bullet points and, you know, all that kind of stuff. Now, in an application form, you can often have the opportunity to talk to somebody about why you're applying. It could be that you are building a relationship with them beforehand, or you've got the opportunity to submit a cover letter. Tell them why you want to work for them.
Yeah.
Don't make them feel like, and this happens all the time, don't make them feel like you've just filled in 5 application forms this week hoping that somebody gives you an interview, because that's a real problem. Because you know, you want to feel special and valued, and so do employers, so do, you know, recruiters, so do organisations. They want to give the opportunity to the person that wants it the most. So when, you know, when you go to these networking events and you meet with people and they just talk about themselves, we've all met people like that, haven't we? Me, and you think they're gonna ask me about me in a minute, and they don't. That's very much what employers feel like when you send them cover letters and application forms, and you don't mention anything about how much you want it. Because it's them. Make them feel like, right now, you are the only person that I really, really want to work for. They will know that's not true, and it's completely cool. But if you want somebody to be genuinely interested in you and to overlook the thought that you might be overqualified, you have to make them feel like you are genuinely interested in them too. I'm not saying you need to look desperate by any means, but you need to make them feel special. So when you're writing a cover letter, don't start with why somebody should pick you. Start with why you pick them, because if you really want to get somebody's attention, you need to start with them. So tell them why, and give them an emotional, emotive reason, not just regurgitating something you've seen on their website or something that, you know, is in their mission statement, or, you know, Google them. I saw an article that you wrote, or I saw something that you had published, and I've thought it, and it's been an inspiration to me since, or it helped me through, you know, my PhD. Make them feel special. And all of these other things, like overqualified, all these other things that are not experienced enough, all of these other things won't necessarily matter so much. And that's from my experience. What would you think about that, Ioanna?
Yeah, exactly the same, because I've been in this situation. I've been in this situation quite recently and for quite a prolonged amount of time where I thought, oh, you know, I'm not getting anywhere because I'm overqualified. And actually, that's not it. It's exactly what you said. It's about, you know, showing your passion for the role, showing how interested you are, and making sure you don't look desperate making sure that basically the employer doesn't see you are one of the five applications I've sent out today, basically. And I think this is where we get it wrong as PhD graduates. Sometimes we so desperately want a job that we end up applying to so many different places, but the interest, the enthusiasm, the passion, it just doesn't come out.
And it's easy to lose that when you're doing application after.
If employers viewing you as overqualified, I think there is actually something where PhDs have to recognise that they are an unknown quantity, they're a career changer. So there might be some legitimacy to that feeling that, are we getting the right person? Yeah. We don't quite know, they're coming from somewhere different. So it's about, again, that translation of your experience into the language and the vocabulary. Yeah. And the setting of that organisation.